Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we are going to do week 11 assignment of Nptel ethical hacking course. So the first question is, which of the following Metasploit module can be used for vulnerability scanning and brute force attack? So the first option, encoder, is used to encode the payload when we are trying to bypass an antivirus. Second, payload is used to specify the payload we are going to use. Exploit is used to specify what we are trying to exploit, a Windows, Linux or Mac OS, any machine. And auxiliary is the Metasploit module, which is used for, you know, brute forcing and vulnerability scanning. So to set port number of the target system in Metasploit framework, which of the following commands is used? So we are trying to set the port number of the target system. So this will be the remote port. So the option is set R port, that is remote port, which is the command for setting the port number of the target machine. So third is, which of the following is our true for Metasploit shell? So whenever we try to exploit anything using Metasploit framework, we can get two kinds of shell. First is Metasploit shell, which is an interactive shell. Second is a standard command line shell. So these two are true. We can get any of these shells, an interactive command shell or a standard command shell. Interactive is the Metasploit one. And we can use Metasploit modules and commands inside Metasploit shell. We can use this Metasploit modules and commands inside Metasploit shell, but we cannot do the same in standard command shell. So these three options are correct. Fourth question, we have, which of the following commands can be used for privilege escalation is Metasploit framework? So the get UID is used to get the current user ID of the machine. That is, whenever you exploit a machine, you don't get to be root, or we can say anti-authority system when it comes to Windows. So whenever we exploit a system, we are basically low level user or www data. So this get UID is used to get the current user we are as on the system. So the get system is the command that is used for privilege escalation is Metasploit framework. Hash dump is used to dump hashes, and PS is used for displaying the process list. To create a payload, that is backdoor, which parameters need to be set in MSF Venom module? So we need to specify the name of the payload. We need to specify the IP address of an attacker system. Attacker system is, that is our system from which we are trying to attack. We need to specify our IP and our port. So the port number of an attacker system, not the target. So question number 6 is, consider the table users consists of three columns, UID, uname and pass as given below. Which of the following SQL queries are malicious with respect to the above table? First is select star, which is asterisk for, you know, I need everything from this users table. So this is not a malicious one. And second is select all from users where UID equals to 5. So there is no UID which is equals to 5. So it will return an empty set. Coming to third option, we have select all from users where uname equals to any. So here again, there is no any user. So the answer that is returned by the database will be empty set. So the coming to last, we have select everything from users where uname equals to any or 1 equals to 1. So there is the malicious, you know, query, because it is specifying that uname equals to any, but it is also specifying an condition, which is or 1 equals to 1, which will always be true, and it will return the whole database. Question number 7th, which, if any web page is vulnerable to blind SQL injection, which of the following is true? It will print error message for incorrect user input. It will not print anything for incorrect user input. It will not print anything for incorrect user input because it is a blind SQL injection. In this injection, whenever we are trying to, you know, find this blind SQL injection, we are trying to do this time-based SQL injection, because in blind case SQL injection, we don't get an output on, you know, performing some incorrect queries. We don't get an output from the database, or we can say the server. So we in this we try to use this time-based SQL injections whenever we are trying to, you know, find blind SQL injections. So coming to 8th question, which of the following tools is used to automate SQL injection attacks? So basically we can use, I think, all of these. when we are trying to do SQL injections. I think there are modules in Metasploit as well, Nmap as well can be used, I think, but as we can only use one option, so I think C should be the correct, because SQL map is the major tool we use to, you know, automate SQL injection attacks. Which of the following options can be used to extract the current username in SQL map? So the dash dash users is to enumerate all users, dash dash current database is to you know enumerate the current database, and dash dash database is for enumerating the database. And dash dash current dash user is used when we want to enumerate the current users. So this is the correct answer for question number 9. And coming to last, which of the following statements is true for reflected cross-site scripting? So it affects all users of that web application. I think this one is correct for stored cross-site scripting, because it gets stored in the database and it is stored in the database of the web application. It is also not true for reflected cross-site scripting, because reflected cross-site scripting doesn't get stored in the database. Stored cross-site scripting does. So it affects only a single client of the web application. I think this should be true for reflected cross-site scripting, and that completes our week 11 assignment of NPTEL Ethical Hacking, and thank you for watching.